Exactly. You're a longtime Trump supporter. You're on my show all the time. What's your response?
Look, I mean, you're always very kind to me, and I'm on here a lot, and you give me a lot of time and are fair to me. I think some of my left-wing counterparts are very unfair to Trump. I think anytime there's any sort of vagueness or gaps in the facts, when there's leaks, for instance, they insert sinister suspicion where it does not belong. I don't think it's you, but I do think some of my left-wing commentators who I disagree with ideologically do that.
The fact that you touched me before you said that is wrong. Don't touch me and then say you launch it to your sinister motivations diatribe.
Okay.
That's not going to happen tonight, ma'am.
I didn't realize there's a one-inch barrier where I'm not allowed to, get close to you, Charles Blow. But now I know, so I'll scoot over this way a tad bit.
You can scoot until you fall off that ledge.
Okay.
I'm telling you is don't touch me.
But Charles, this is the problem. This is the problem, and it was what you just said to me is a lot like what Maxine Waters said today when she said, look, don't ask to meet with me, President Trump. I don't even want to meet with you. We're all Americans. Maybe you don't feel that way. We have one president. We should all want him to succeed, and we should all be friends at the end of the day and hug it out. And if you don't want to do that, you don't have to do that.
You're about to turn this from a civil conversation into me telling...
Because we're all Americans.
No, ma'am.
Because we're all Americans.
Because now that's a very personal attack to say that I don't... I'm an American. Maybe I don't believe that I'm an American. Don't do that.
You said I'm not even allowed to touch you.
No,
that is just like what Maxine Waters said.
No, you're not.
Go ahead.
Sad has been, if you want it to be sad.
Go ahead.
I'm telling you, don't do that.
Go ahead.
The president.